I was saying, I did not only have campground, I was river view, go down the river.
Yeah.
And I forgot to call it.
That's not late, that's the most interesting thing. About 10 o'clock, maybe 10:30, the second week.
Sure, I can be away from there at 1.
All of a sudden, everybody's phone.
Morning. How are you this morning?
I'm getting there.
Oh, okay.
And you should have seen the, I was standing.
Morning.
Hey, Ken.
I was Mr. Ozzy.
Oh, he's, what is?
Did I pronounce that right? Okay. I wanted to make sure.
He's in turmoil over all this.
Oh, I don't blame him. He's, but he's here to stay.
Yeah.
Okay. At least he didn't get hung up somewhere.
No. Not yet anymore. But he listens to all the phone news, especially the Middle East.
Oh, I would have made it so. Why wouldn't he?
All in Arabic, so I don't understand.
Were you impressed with the press conference?
I don't know what to make of it.
If it wasn't so.
I know.
Yeah, isn't there?
No, I haven't watched an article about, because I haven't been on Pearl Street.
I wish I could find something.
More corporate.
It's not really.
It's not really, yeah.
Looking into the.
Still kind of got the local flavor.
Oh!
I don't know as if that's how they phrased it, but it made.
Yeah, yeah.
Incompetent.
Yeah.
Might have been that one.
Incompetent.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. I'd vote for that.
Like Miss Jaws getting bought out by Walmart or something like that. Moose Jaw, it's like an outdoor outfit.
Did you notice the press stood up there yesterday?
There's no way that we can't sell.
Fed up with him that it's just unreal.
Yeah.
They pay high rates and they're really good prices.
Yeah.
Patagonia.
Yeah.
Which is like, you know, they actually only have 6 stores.
Oh, yeah. But they had him somebody else.
So that's really good.
I had heard that Morning Joe. They blackballed that Kellyanne from coming on there.
Yeah.
Morning Joe.
There's a big.
Yeah.
Or you'd get like.
Well, I think we get tired of her not being informed, doesn't know what's going on, and I don't know if they worded it this way, but why?
And city council, they never, I'm involved in downtown Boulder. They just decided that was 2 weeks ago or something, to just do this moratorium.
Stay tuned. Yeah, it does.
That has a camera behind it, so be careful what you say.
There is a camera.
Any downtown, I mean, that's pretty.
Has to do with leaks.
That's why, yeah, that's why I always sit with my back to the camera.
And those are the people that have the money.
I don't know.
You never know.
Yeah.
Yeah, right?
I think it was kind of a perfect story that there's a bunch of empty storefronts, not a bunch, there's just some. And then there's the capital, that was a big thing, there's a capital one that came in right here.
I used your ready second.
There's always been banks on Pearl Street.
I should have signed the one lower than you would have been above.
And we go, you know, we take.
We asked Denzel if he wanted to be in the lady.
Above Fresh Produce for summer.
Great green summer.
They go down there to banking during the day, so.
Right. Start sliding in the mud.
His great-grandson rolled in a big truck down in Oklahoma. He was in the hospital the other day when.
The rent is so insane. That's the.
What is it per square foot or something? I read it. It's insane, yeah.
He says, the comment his grandson made was, I run over my pork rinds.
Yeah.
Apparently everything spilled out of the truck when he flipped it.
She's okay?
And, yeah, well, he was in the hospital, he's got some scratches and bruises. But he says, something about, he really doesn't need those, he's on a diet, he's weighs over 300 pounds.
Whoa.
Yeah, or weighs 300 pounds. He says, pork rinds is really not something you should carry.
Whoa.
Denzel's so slim.
So, Lindsay,
Yes.
So all that stuff.
I'm using this right hand. I am. I'm not a dexterous or whatever it is. My dad was, because they trained him when he was in kindergarten, you know, to use his, back in those days.
I was the same, well, I don't know about kindergarten, but first grade.
Hey, how's it going?
And I could write either left or right. My teacher decided that I should be right-handed. And that's where I ended up getting switched.
But you were naturally left.
Well, yeah.
No, we could print off with them.
Oh, really? Okay. Okay.
Who? Oh!
That would be cool.
I can do that.
Well, then, yeah.
Where the spaces are.
It's an example, yeah.
I'm not sure.
Okay.
I think I can have someone at my work do it.
Oh, last set, was it last? Oh, yeah, yeah, okay.
Oh, well, I can do it.
But this.
It trashed it, because everybody that's gonna be here is here.
Ready to see trustee do it all?
But I'm.
Oh, okay. Well, I.
If you can get me the photo.
Oh, no, she got a skate today.
Even if you send me, if all those newspapers are online or something, I can just grab it.
Okay, so I'll work on it.
Yeah, I was like, just in a.
Just give me an inch to pay.
Are you here, or are you a 100 miles?
No, I'm somewhere else.
I just wanted to worry about something.
Oh.
Oh, good.
Alan isn't here, because she has a dental.
Okay, everybody, it's seven after my, took it on my wrist here, so. I was kind of waiting for trustee to dissolve. Bob Morgan isn't planning on being here today, because it sounds like, I talked to him yesterday, it sounds like the demands for Jane are highest in the morning. So, for example, you have occupational therapists and physical therapists and home health care coming in, and so he just felt like he needs to stay home. What's what he's been saying about the openings on Saturday, too, so. Sounds like she's repairing reasonably well, but it's just a big setback here. Breaks were pretty significant. Jill is confined to the plant now in an office at the IBM plant, so she's pretty frustrated, I think.
Okay.
She is. Yeah, because she can't, doesn't have the flexibility she used to have, so she isn't able to do the phone either, because she's physically in an office. So.
Is she there permanently, or is this just a temporary?
At this point, it's permanently, and it's an open office space, so they just have to keep it. So it's a big change for her. I think she said she was 20-some years working from home, so.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Chained to the desk.
Alan has an appointment this morning, and so welcome back, everybody, and so we forge on throughout the year, our new year 2017, and good to see everybody. And meeting's hereby called to order, and a big thank you to Gail for her job. I guess we'll start with, oh, we need to have a moment of silence. Brian had a tremendous sacrifice. Spend the week in Florida.
Oh.
Really sympathize with you on that.
Yeah,
so tired now that you're back.
70s and sunny, it was rough.
Yeah. Yeah. Humid though. Humid.
It wasn't too bad here either.
Well, that's the thing, yeah. I was hoping to have
but the, no ocean.
Yeah.
Well, it was a dirty job, Brian, but somebody had to
somebody,
do it. Thank
yeah.
you for gotta, sacrificing.
Gotta use that training budget, you know.
Well, you were training what?
His kids.
Yeah, all the above.
Trying to train him.
That Dr. Mann about this.
Yes, I think so.
Hey, now.
It's called the David Campbell. Okay, so Karen, would you mind doing the 3 minutes, please?
Superior Historical Commission meeting minutes, January 20th. Meeting was called to order by Chairperson Larry Dorsey. In attendance were commission members Mary Cartwright, Larry Dorsey, Lindsay Llewellyn, Katie Olson, Jill Roberts, Errol Walden Wolgorski and Karen Wolgorski. Staff Brian Meyer, Town Board Trustee Rita Dozell, and others, Maureen Hogue, Alan Jarrett, and Gail Cassana. Our new Town Board Liaison Rita Dozell was introduced. The minutes of the November 18th meeting were read. Wally Wolgorski moved they be approved as amended. Mary Cartwright seconded the motion, and the motion carried. The treasurer's reports were given as follows. Brian reported for Bob Morgan that the fire truck account currently has a balance of $275. Then he indicated it was going to zero. Brian reported that there's $2,975 in the 2017 historic preservation account. The capital improvement account has a balance of $25,000. Old business debriefings were discussed as follows. Cinda Arsenault came to the January 7th museum opening and donated some sewing notions from the 1940s. The Count the Lights holiday event on December 3rd was very well attended. Rita suggested at the town board meeting that perhaps lights could be put on an old piece of equipment in a future year. Christmas potluck on December 11th was enjoyed by all, and the new location at the Summit Clubhouse was a great room for the event with plenty of space and nice accommodations. Our thanks to Walt and Carol. Larry reported on the Boulder Heritage Roundtable. The Square Nail Awards will be coming up in May. No one attended the NFRAM meeting at the Lakewood Heritage Center on December 19th. Mary attended the Lafayette Historical Society meeting featuring Bob Mulder on January 14th. The cataloging filing committee reported progress is being made. Brian reported that a new computer will be installed in the near future with new past perfect software. There was no news reported on the oral history video QR project. There is no news on the Superior Information in Wikipedia project. Brian reported that Mile High Classics is ready to begin additional work on the fire truck, including interior work on the upholstery, pinstriping the gold leaf pattern previously on the exterior of the truck, and work on the exhaust system. The commission moved to proceed with the work with a goal for completion by July 4th. Motion by Wally Wolgorski, seconded by Katie Olson. Wally also brought up the question of whether all the gauges on the dash are functioning properly. Karen reported that a Get Well card was sent to Danny Kuffner in the hospital. A Get Well card needs to be sent to Jane Morgan, and a thank you note to Cinda Arsenault for her donation. Brian reported that the iron railing has been installed on the back porch of the museum. The park staff has met with Larry to discuss potential solutions for the slope on the back porch. Katie and Alan discussed future museum display ideas. March is National Women's History Month. A display about Josephine Roach will be a part of that month. The commission discussed writing a letter to the town board by the February meeting expressing the importance of the developer, expressing the importance for the developer of the town center to include an access road to and parking at the entrance to the cemetery. Four of the commission members volunteered to work on this letter. New business. Staffing for the February 4th museum opening was discussed. The next ANFRAM meeting is February 20th. Brian announced that our membership in ANFRAM has been renewed for 2017. Wally announced that he went to visit Danny Kuffner with some cheese, salami, and crackers. All were glad to hear that he is getting better and having had rabbit fever. The CPI Saving Places Conference is in Denver, February 1st through 4th. Lindsay Llewellyn is interested in attending this year. commission leadership was discussed, including who would be willing to serve in 2017. The elections will take place in the February meeting. The spring education program was discussed. A tentative date of April 20th was proposed. Larry will contact the University of Denver students, Jenna Wheaton and Laura Vernon, to see if they would be interested in doing their program related to their archaeological project at the industrial mine site. Alan reported on her temperature and humidity readings at the museum. The 68-degree temperature is good, but the humidity readings have a great variation from 40 to 65. Brian will have the humidifier checked. Lindsay passed out some very interesting pie charts on the nationalities of people living in Superior and Louisville in 1900 and 1930. While I move, the meeting be adjourned at noon, and Larry seconded the motion. Next meeting is February 17th.
Any additions or corrections? Sound right on there. Karen?
If I can, I'd like to make a comment. And Trustee Giselle had talked about maybe, and this, I'm not talking about changing minutes, it's just a comment, about maybe taking machinery up there by the museum for Christmas at that time and putting lights on it. I don't know, is that something we really want to do? Because that's going to involve trying to move that up there, and some of that's not good enough shape to put up there. You know, I don't have any problems decorating whatever. I just don't know if we want to try and drag the machinery up there.
I probably tend to agree with you on how realistic that is.
Well, especially
not now.
I just want to emphasize this. This is totally a comment on that particular thing.
Mary's like thinking.
On that. That isn't really, we're not highlighting agricultural heritage up there at all. It's the school and the mining, really. And the agricultural's down here at Grassland Park. So.
And I think it's nice to have it history themed, but I don't know if that's the best way to do it.
If they want to decorate machinery down in the park for Christmas, I don't have a problem with that.
Was there a motion to accept the minutes as read?
I so
moved. Second?
Second.
We got an acclamation on that, I think. Thank you again, Karen.
It's a historic preservation account balance is $2,935.
Okay, something got spent.
I think it was Amfram and CWAM. So I think it was probably the CWAM membership. CWAM, yeah.
Thank you.
And the other account, is that still
$25,000? Yeah, the historic fire truck CIP account, yeah, $25,000.
No, you have this capital improvement account. Karen, is that capital improvement?
I mean, it is a capital improvement account. In a general sense, it is, yeah.
Capital improvement for the fire truck.
Capital improvement for the fire truck, yeah.
Will we have another capital improvement on some?
Well, I don't think there is any allocated for that, but I would imagine if there is a need for something at the museum or the park, it can more than likely come from that account.
Okay.
If there's anything that comes up, so.
Thank you. The museum is open on February 4th, and that's how I left. I think we had one visitor came to see Wallace talking. Mm-hmm. Yep. Anybody come?
signed the guest book.
Yeah, I think he did.
Yeah.
I remember his name.
He was there before I got there.
Yeah.
Nobody came after.
Yeah, him and his wife were there.
Okay, him and daughter. Okay, so these four people now. Walt was given an award that morning, so that was kind of nice. Okay, Lindsay, you went to the CPI Saving Places Conference, and what did you learn?
So I went to 2 days of the actual conference, and then because of what I'm doing at History Colorado, I also went to the Historic Commission Camp. It's an all-day thing on this Saturday. I went to like a mining, historic mining session, and some other local government sessions. I just really felt like we should start thinking more about long-term goals about what we want to accomplish. Because I feel like a lot of what we've been doing recently is very like year-to-year sort of, like we have a fire truck project, but I'm not sure what other long-term goals we have beyond getting that finished, other than just sort of maintaining status quo and, you know, rescuing the museum. So that was just what I've been really thinking about throughout the conference, with what different sessions were emphasizing. And then with that, I was wondering if we wanted there to be some sort of historic presence in the new town center area, like, you know, over by Target, there's a miner statue and things like that, so should there be something like that across McCaslin? And then I also thought that it might be helpful to, we had talked about maybe having some sort of organization or something, but at least starting with maybe volunteer or friends sign up so that we could come up with things for other people to do to get involved in, you know, historic related things in Superior. So yeah, I actually typed up a bunch of notes, but I didn't have time to print them off this morning, so.
Can you send those out?
Yeah. Those are the main things that I really felt like would be important for us to consider coming out of the conference. And so now I'm doing work with the Certified Local Government program, you know, through History Colorado. And I think that we're really close to being like something. I don't think it's something that we would be close to being able to do. But it is, you know, Boulder County has a certain local government, and Louisville, Brookfield, and Lafayette, and Erie. You know, we talked about this before, but I do think it'd be nice to have more contact with other local communities and see how they work their historical traditions.
What do you do in the certified government?
So, what I'm going to be doing is, so there's 57 certified local governments across the state, and those are the people, if you have a certified local government, then you can give tax, or the people in your towns can get tax credits for any work done on their historic properties. And then you can also get separate funding for different projects that's just set aside for those, and it's federal funding for different projects. And unlike the state historical fund, you don't have to match funds at all, so it's really nice in that way. So what I'll be doing is, they're putting together a database of ordinances and regulations that the 57 different towns and counties have like in their areas, so that you can like call up the guy that's in charge of it and see what other people have done. So not everybody is just inventing everything out of thin air. And then we're also just like going through the different projects different certified local governments have done and to see other information on them, so that publicized better.
Yeah. How old is it?
This. The Certified Local Government? Well, it's a federal program, and I want to say it's been around since the 70s? I don't know, but yeah, I'm not exactly sure. But yeah, being a certified local government means that your citizens can get the tax credits if they're doing work on a historic property.
Where's your office?
I'm just, this is part of my internship at History Colorado, so.
Oh, yeah, you're right, History Colorado.
Yeah.
The fun museum. Well, so that's a good thought there, huh? Prioritizing brings back to the, what our long-term goals are, I guess, I would say.
Yeah, I don't know if we have like a five-year plan or something.
Do those annual, or work plans for the, each year, but we do think that far ahead, but, yeah, that's, that's really the cause is to really stop and think about the long-term goals and pathway for this organization.
Well, I like Lindsay's idea about possibly putting, like a statue or something over in here, and I wondered if somewhere down, somewhere we should start trying to figure out where we're gonna, we can get the funding, and if we can get it, then we still have contact with some of the artists that we had for over here, and if we can get the funding, then maybe pursue getting in touch with them and see about getting something going.
They started up an arts commission now, right?
Oh, they are?
Who's the
Well, that would be.
Yeah, it's, what is the name of it again?
Cultural.
Yeah, CAPS is the acronym. But anyhow, so Katie Rummel in our department is the staff liaison. For that group, yeah, and I know they have a.
Yeah, that'd be, I think that's a terrific idea.
Yeah.
It's a mystery over there.
Yep.
It's so brand new.
If they have that, that's going now, maybe that would be something to present them with.
Seems like when they got these various pieces of artwork out here, including the sculpture of the miner, so forth, that was a contest, wasn't it? They have a citywide contest, or a contest sponsored by the town to, people submit.
So like you can.
Oh, it's on the.
It's on the website.
I was part of that art committee back at that time, and that was something that was well, it was passion for.
Yeah.
Way back.
Like in a couple of years, coming soon, yeah.
Yeah, for the art movement.
Yeah, Sandy Pennington.
Yeah, it was Joe Camel.
Even lives around here anymore, he used to live just down the street from us.
Yeah.
Well, I would like, I think, I'm assuming that commission is meeting.
Yeah.
Maybe we should have someone from this organization.
Meeting on the fourth Thursday of each month, from 6 to 7:30 PM. But yeah, I mean.
Yeah, if they're doing any like children's art related things, it would be cool if we could do like a kids history related art project or something.
Yeah, but we had a couple of them, I think over by, what is it, Whole Foods? I don't know, is that still there? We had a kids deal over there, so yeah, that's definitely something.
Well, that's where they were stolen.
Yeah, and then they were replaced.
They got stolen.
So yeah, that's definitely something.
Fastened down, even though they were very heavy.
Why don't we do a, think about it, I don't know if we want to do, now to wrap this up, but think about having a, an evening session where we do a long-range plan.
Yeah, and think about each of the sites that, you know, we have interest in having. What we
did
want to see happen with those.
Sure, I think it's a good idea.
Yeah, Marie suggests
a
contest.
Yeah.
One time a guy stopped into the museum, and he has a, I don't know, his business card. He had a work of art in his house, the sculpture of his house in the line. He was in a contest and didn't win, so there's still some stuff around.
Oh, yeah.
And he was on display.
We can pursue different things than what we have already.
Or I like the idea of in those buildings to do a, if there's like a long hallway, you know, to do like a walking collage of photos and maps, and that would be neat too. So I'll email, I'll get the person's contact info that's in charge if you guys want me to for that CAPS and.
Okay.
We can maybe see if we could go to one of their start emailing them about it.
Well, it's just getting started, I recall, so.
Yeah, there was a meeting December. Yeah, it's just kind of evolving right now. I'll bring this up now. I guess Starbucks had recently contacted the town, and Martin Toth had been in touch with them. And I think they're in the process, if they haven't already, of displaying some historic photos throughout their location over there. So if you happen to go over there, you may see. I think Martin sent him the photos from the, many of them from the Lost Superior book, but anyhow.
Here's Mr. Morgan.
Mr. Morgan.
And then also thinking about this, you know, since we could possibly put up something here in the town hall.
If you could email out what else you wanted, that would be really great.
Katie's idea about a hallway out there, the sports stadium's got all kinds of iron.
I was just thinking that same thing, yeah.
Morning, Mr. Bob.
Morning. Yeah, that's what I need, applause.
You do.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine. Brian, how you doing? Good to see everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it was worth your time, it sounds like.
Yeah, I thought it's really interesting.
It's really nice for you to get there, so keep us updated on what ideas that you were spurred by being here. I went to the roundtable meeting yesterday, so the dates for the Square Nail Award this year is May 15th at Chautauqua Cottage there, and
auditorium.
Yeah, the little auditorium. It's called Community Center. And so right now they're getting together, starting to pull together some of the awards that might be happening. There's the next program at Chautauqua. Chautauqua's had a series of programs that are very good. That one in Field Tate, I think it's last week. It's about women and the Colorado Hall of Fame. And here's a calendar that Historic Boulder and Carnegie Library put together.
We sell those. They're 50% off right now.
Okay, she's giving them away to Carnegie Library, so. Some images,
No, I think that mostly they get them from Carnegie.
Okay. Nice little calendar. Other than that, that's about all coming out of the round table, I think. Gailey, you want to have the next one?
Oh,
number two.
Can we pass?
Pass.
What's cataloging?
means
we've been busy doing that.
We've been busy, yeah. So no cataloging.
Larry's been busy.
No oral history video update.
Oral history update?
Is the computer, we have the computer. Is the computer and software in there yet?
No, it hasn't happened yet, but
okay.
It'll, you know, right now RIT, ladies are pretty busy with our departments moving across the street at the sports table over the next week. So that Parks and Rec building across the street eventually is, from what I'm told, is going to get bulldozed. And so we're in the process of moving over there. And it's going to happen, yeah. So maybe, I don't know, if the group's interested, whether it's next month's meeting, we have the community room over there. Other committees have had their monthly meeting over there. Just, I can give you guys a tour of the building if you've never been over there. So we can certainly do that.
I think that'd be a neat idea. The day Brian and Patrick took me for that, I was just awestruck by the place. So they could do that for the next week in March.
Yeah, I'll check the see if that room's available, and if so, I'll let you guys know.
Not one, if we want to bug you, we have to find you over there.
Yeah.
Thomas Mahal.
It's a maze, yeah. We're not there yet, but yeah.
So the new pass perfect?
Yeah, so it's not installed yet, yeah. I mean, I wish I could say yes it was, but it's not yet.
Yeah. All right.
Well, I will keep it brief, Lindsay. I wasn't sure how much room you had on your posters for pictures and books. But yes, I can add to it. I think I can email it to you this weekend.
Oh, great.
Yes.
What
did you say?
My email told her to ask about how she was saying last time her mom remembered Josephine Roche coming to visit.
Yeah, just the latest is they have our signed their proposal for the work, and we're just waiting to hear from them when they have one of their bays opened up, one of their large bays, to have the truck there for an extended amount of time to do the work. So they know of the July 4th deadline, so I just don't know that date yet when it's going to get in there, so it should be shortly.
They were going to do everything, the exhaust and all that.
Well, I think the exhaust work was plan is to maybe take it to a nearby shop that they work with quite a bit.
I'm
yeah.
just saying they were.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I think that's great.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, is it going to be leaving pretty soon?
Yeah, that, it should, I just don't have a date yet, but it will be, yeah, shortly, yeah. I think Matt's going to be taking it for a spin here shortly, his monthly. Just get the fluids flowing and make sure it's still around. Yeah,
right.
Blow the dust off.
Yeah. Well, correspondence, Madam Secretary.
Okay, we sent a get well card to Jane Morgan.
Yeah, thank you. thanks everybody. Yeah.
And a thank you note to Cinda Arsenal for the sewing notions.
I darn them every once in a while. Darn sucks.
Okay. Did we have any other donations that I've missed here?
I don't think so. Well, we have Mary. Mary Cartwright donated a pair of shoes.
Oh, yes.
Do
you have a PDF of that?
I will.
Send me,
yeah.
Thanks.
Well, we'll talk about it.
Next display on
Josephine Roche. I'm passing around some flyers. I didn't bring enough for everyone, but we are working on it. Lindsay came up with all the content and lots of good info. So we need to, I guess, just get a poster together for it. And I can send out these, unless you guys want me to make any changes, which I can. I made this very quickly this morning. So there's probably misspellings, or if you want me to change anything, I can. I need to work with you, Brian, on getting a flyer for you. Did you guys, is the email already been sent out for this month or whatever?
Well, the February newsletter, town newsletter has, but Melissa Miller, I think you know her, yeah, she'll be, she usually sends an email to me and Larry and some other people. So the March one, she compiles that in late February.
Okay, so we're okay. So we're okay, if I get you the flyer, or both of you guys the flyer. And I would love to request a separate email if possible. You guys did that for us before, it was really great. We don't really have much else going on with this event. You know, we did the ice cream social last time and we did a flyer. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if a separate, I don't know. Do you guys think we should do a separate email to try and get people, if we can?
Were you going to contact Eleanor McGinn?
Yeah. Was I going to do that?
Well, I don't know. I think you said you had her contact
information. Excuse me.
I got a piece of a letter in my dad's file from Josephine Roach. I don't know whether you would
that'd be great. Because we actually, so we'll do a nice poster, but we don't have that much material. I mean, we said, of course, the day of, we can highlight the mining equipment. And we could, but we don't have that much. Yeah. And maybe Lindsay might do some
this
copies
of
newspapers.
This is a letter when she's a trustee for the pension, miners' pension. And
That'd be great.
So I'd like to have it back, of course. But
that'd be great.
I don't know how to get it to you.
If you just bring it on, or either way, if you come to the opening or. Or you could leave it here someday. I don't know. We can.
Bob, could I suggest you make a copy and give us the copy? And
sure.
You just keep the original?
I can do that real easy. Yeah,
and
sure.
And then you could just mail it.
Sure, I can do that. Yeah, I can do that. Yeah.
Okay. Great. That'd be great. But
Could I ask that we have a little short bio about Josephine, so when people come in on the 4th, we can say more than, well, yeah, she took over the. You know, so we know something to say, because I don't know very much about her.
I can just email out the sheet I put together.
Mm-hmm.
So just have like little, it's like five paragraphs that are about different things in her life.
I did this for a historian on her, so.
Yeah. Maybe, Lindsay, you could send that link too, since you had that link in your other email, right?
Yeah.
That would be good, though. Yeah. So next week, I think I've got a deal. Next week's the deadline.
Yeah, I don't think Melissa sent an email yet, but
I think they got
one. Did you get one? Yeah. Yeah, so it should be, I guess February is coming to an end.
I'm building up to here, though, if we need to do the same thing for our spring program. Two nights to put in the Sentinel, this in March and the spring program in April. So we start to preliminary scoop out to the program.
Guys have any changes to this?
Do you want to do light refreshments and snacks or anything?
Good.
It wouldn't hurt.
To add
that to
say
it?
Say that
know.
We're doing something.
People like that?
Sure.
Yeah.
And then I'll email all of this out. I'll email this to all of you. And I think what we did before, hopefully if you can print some yourself and put some at the town and put them wherever you guys go, that would be really awesome too. Or email to the Louisville person or Lafayette.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That would be great.
We can do that. I'm thinking it might be nice to have a scripter in front of owner, like a benevolent owner.
Sure. And she was.
What great tagline you and Alan had come up with originally, but
I just took from. Did she say something? Was it something?
Compassionate owner.
Very interesting person.
And
progressive owner.
And can you say that it was industrial minded Superior?
Superior's industrial minded.
Yeah. I know it's a Superior Historical Museum, but
nobody knows industrial mine. I'm not, no, but if you're in Hospital or someplace else, you would know. Don't recognize that. It's, they think it's a superior mine.
Because we have superior coal.
No, I mean, that's part of it.
Which actually was all that good, but.
Very good.
And then if we could give this to the Louisville Library too, for them to post. Do we do that too?
Yeah.
Do we, you send it to the Louisville Historical Commission, I think.
I send it to Louisville Historical Museum.
Museum, I mean.
I mean, I can drop that.
But yeah, take it to the, they'll post it at the library too, the Louisville Library, that would be great.
I don't know if, I think Bridget might coordinate that. Or I'll check to make sure.
Okay. Because I mean, I'm late, I'm apologizing, we were doing a tour of the Old Valley Ice Building with the Louisville Council and Louisville staff. So it went longer, it started at 9:00 and I thought I'd be done by 10:00 and then I looked at my watch and go, oh.
Were they impressed?
They were very impressed. They couldn't believe when they got inside that building and how big and how many activities there are within it.
Do you want me to get you, why don't I try calling Albert and get to see if she's still.
In the area?
Yeah. She lives over Lafayette, but I think they're going to go to the independent living or something like that. Senior.
Thanks for your work, everybody on this.
Yes, thank you. So what are you going to have on display, by the way?
Well, we still have
no idea.
Bob's letter.
See what other materials.
Bob's letter.
I'm going to go to.
Bob's letter.
That's it.
I'm going to go to, her papers are at New Orleans, at CU Library, so talk with them and see if there's any newspapers about her visiting Superior or anything like that. If you get copies of it.
And a board, a board like we did for Ms. Orange.
Okay. Oh, yeah, we still need better.
That's why, I guess that's why I was only asking.
Hanging things, yeah, yes.
Very good. Okay, the letter to the Board of Trustees is finished. Don't want a revision, so the commission can stay afterward and maybe we can stay afterward and sign and give it to you.
Okay, all right.
I think that's our procedure. And spring program, I meant to contact Laura and Jenna yesterday and I didn't, so they were just, they jumped on it right away and confirmed it, so I'll contact them over the weekend and get started getting together some of their publicity materials so we can put together a poster for so that's April 20th at 7 p.m. right here on the stage. And last month we were going to try and get together, I see it's down in the in business, the future events exhibit brochure. I think it really qualifies as old business since we almost did it once last month. So Katie, you want to see about getting together to try once again to herd this bunch of cats into a brochure?
I mean, I guess I just wanted to talk, we can just talk at this meeting or at next month's meeting about ideas. So I mostly, I guess, if we do a brochure, then we need to have some good, the thought would we do have some like events that we're listing here, like the 4th of July parade and
Story Walk.
Yeah, so we need dates for those things.
And maybe when there'll be new displays and stuff like that.
Yeah, display ideas. Maybe not display ideas because it'd be nice. I guess so. I guess we could change it every year, change a brochure every year to have. But I think most people liked the idea of doing a brochure. We just have to figure out what. Obviously, a lot of it would just be basic information when we're open. But then, like I said, it would be nice to list some special events
Well, some of those, like the Victoria Walk is always on the second Saturday of May.
Second Saturday or the first Saturday?
First, my mistake.
But that's good when it's a particular Saturday rather than a date.
Yeah, so that could have been in there.
Do you think that if we're putting together information like that, we've talked before about having a website that might go along with whatever we're getting together for a brochure, and then just put that on the website as well?
You know, I think we can probably just use...
The towns.
The towns.
Right, have a separate page.
Yeah.
We have our basic page and then...
And then add to it there, you know, everything interactive stuff there.
I think that would probably be the best thing for the park, is not creating a whole new, but...
It'd just be nice to have a map with the historic sites like marked up.
I think, I mean, the website for the commission, that page is actually, it's pretty good right now, but definitely could be livened up a little bit. I think even having like, just like brief video testimonials from maybe commission members, like at each of the, like Grasso or Assy or something like that. I don't know, something to, you know.
That's a good idea.
You know.
And articles, are the articles posted on, like on our page?
Which articles?
Like the article that you wrote?
Historical.
What did you write?
Spirit historians?
Yeah.
They're accessible.
On our page though?
Accessible two or three different ways, through publications and through historical commission page. I think maybe Parks and Recreation. At least two of them is in those, yeah. But I still think it's nice to have a whole website.
Well, you could almost, something to think about, a compromise on that would be just create your web address, you know, shc.com or Superior, sort of, and then it can just direct it right to the town's, I mean, the town's page for it.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
So, right. So you kind of have your own, you could really market that link, you know, and it'll just go to the town's.
We need some of the younger people
I have.
On the commission to handle those things. Not an old guy, but still retired. Built a website for the old film. Museum and stuff.
So what else would be in the brochure?
Well, let's see. Okay, so brochure would have the all the essential information like open times, location, who, what, where, when, I guess. Some visuals, photograph of the museum.
Awesome. And,
exterior and interior. I took an interior shot and had the, excuse me, Ms. Warman display up. It really came out nice. I put it in my slideshow. So I think it'd make a good photograph of the interior of the museum. We could just have a single sheet, the front and back.
We could do anything, yeah.
Trifold or bifold or anything like that.
I had a sample one from, it's actually the town next to my grandparents' town. There's a historical commission, I guess, had a brochure that I thought was good. And it talked about like if you wanted access to the museum, if you could contact, you know, you don't just have to.
That'd be good for the open hours and or by appointment.
Yeah, it's like, you know, scouting troop wanted to come or something.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
You
could even
handle
that lock, don't you think?
Yeah, well,
or in
have,
here.
You have them here too.
Yeah. If they had like a, it's like a, almost like a real estate, you know, plastic.
Yeah, where you lift it up and pick up.
Yeah. On their museum and then put it in
there.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, because it's our only like Yelp review for the museum is somebody who thought that it was just like a model house.
Oh.
And they came by on a Thursday or something.
Oh.
And they're like, oh, there's a model of a house. And yeah, it was completely wrong.
Yeah.
But anyway, it'd be nice to have information that they could take if it's not open.
Let's all start doing Yelp reviews.
$650,000 they go, wow, that's superior people to send there.
They can't see inside because you close all the shades.
Yeah, that's right.
Nobody knows what's inside.
Then the brochure have the definite dates, the definite events like spring program in April, Sword Hawk in May, Fourth of July parade, Count the Lights, open and count the lights in December.
First Saturday in December.
Just make it more general.
That's what I'm doing, first Saturday.
It's always the first Saturday.
Or it has been.
Yeah, coordinate with the descending.
Count the lights at the.
Did AmCrab give up their brochure that they were putting together? Wasn't it AmCrab that had all the listings on?
Yeah, the latest model, definitely, publication, so. Yeah, we can put the AmCrab brochure and the Arbison brochure out there.
And then I think one thing we talked about in the past was, do we pick another, in advance, pick another parade like Louisville that we are going to be a part of ahead of time? You know, that other one was really last minute, and we talked last year about if we plan ahead better, do we want to be a part? Was that the Labor Day?
Yeah,
what?
Labor Day in Louisville, yeah. That's the other one I think we talked about.
They do Christmas too.
I think I counted a red light something.
And that's the Friday before our Count the Lights at the end of Saturday, so. And also it's dark. I mean, no, obviously. So the Labor Day, people could see whatever we put out.
Yeah, we put it in another parade I planned ahead because at this point I have a town employee trying to be a board member.
Well, maybe this summer we need to talk. That wouldn't necessarily be in the brochure, but, you know, we need to talk about signing up for, you know, what the date is, all that stuff.
Put a picture of the fire truck in the brochure too.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
Okay.
This is for the first one.
Okay. All right, well, maybe I'll start working on a brochure.
And I just have, and Larry, I just have one quick thing to add to that.
Oh, yeah.
I know I mentioned the rooftop drops that the chamber does. Katie, I'll give this to you, but anyhow, the next drop that they're going to do is in April. It's going to be at 1,000 households. So the main thing is any information. So if the brochure is done by then, if it is by mid-April, because they want the material, like the chamber wants it the middle of the month that they do it. That's a good opportunity to go to 1,000 homes.
And
so
how much is it?
It'll be free, yeah. And we can
free
make
for us.
Free for us, yeah, free for us. You're right, yeah. Chamber members, standard members, $45 per drop, I think.
Well, that would be awesome.
But yeah, it's pretty inexpensive. Mm-hmm. But the opportunity is that they only do a quarter of the households each quarter. Mm-hmm. You know, so they do a drop every quarter.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a map
so they,
on the
they
second
split
page.
The column up into four segments. Yeah. And then they drop.
And do you guys, does the town normally do this, or could we have all four of these?
You could have all four.
Could.
The town, I don't think, has ever dropped anything in the night.
Yeah, rarely, yeah.
Could sometimes put a letter in there.
Sometimes, yeah. But, and I don't know, candidates and stuff that put stuff in. But, you know, it's usually, but yeah, I think you should plan for that, is have that next four, so that you get the whole town covered in the next year.
Do we know, is it possible just as a home publishing to do these brochures like you do your, like one does one's business cards, for example?
Yeah, there's lots of places online that you can even design them online.
Yeah.
Right.
And I guess the question is figuring out how much content we have. Do we do just the like glossy front back? Do we do the open and, you know, I don't think we need four. I don't know.
I don't think
we don't have tons of info, but
I think it's also back to back and probably to start
have
out
enough.
With, yeah. I was thinking a map might be good too.
Yeah.
A map of the different
town
things.
The tool.
Sure.
Absolutely.
So that would maybe
Absolutely.
Be a bigger one. Yeah. We don't have a map right now, right? So we just have to create that. I mean, do we just do a Google map and do stars?
A map of
Our spots, just of our of the parks.
Can you just use Google Maps?
Yeah, I guess you probably could, and just mark, do the pin drops or something.
Yeah.
was, yeah, I've been looking at mapping stuff.
All right.
Can I make a comment about that, and about this calendar? Boulder County Open Space, Parks and Open Space, does a real small little calendar that I get every year as a trustee. It, we'll do this, it's actually, they're square, and has a picture, some kind of historical or a parks, picture of a park or a branch or something that's preserved. And then they have the month under it, you know, and then they put it out on, basically, which is like a CD, plastic CD holder, you know, and you can stand it up, and then they all sit in there, and I love those pictures, because I'll cut off, you know, the picture off of the, and the calendar in the bottom, and I've even framed a couple of them, because they're so interesting, the pictures are great. I don't know if we need more calendars, but if we ever did a calendar, instead of doing a big one like this, the idea of having one that can sit on your desk and you, you know, put a picture on, or even I was thinking of like baseball cards of famous women or famous places in Superior, you know, like little trading cards.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you could put the picture on the front and then information on the back, make it for a future idea. But when I saw this, I thought, oh, wouldn't that be kind of fun to have a picture of like Josephine, and then on the back they have the information, or we can go to the kids and give presentations to them and stuff, give them out and say, what do you think this is? And then they can flip over the back and see. It's kind of like, well, we talked about games or questions and stuff. And then can I add another couple of a new business now? Are we ready for that? Or?
I think we are, yeah.
Starbucks that just opened right over here, Starbucks over here, has asked if we could provide historical pictures to hang inside the building.
Oh, great.
And so, have you talked about that?
Oh, right? Yeah, that's fine. Okay. I mentioned it. From what I understand, I think Martin's been in touch with them or has sent them photos. But yeah, you may know more than I do about it. But
it happened at the ribbon cutting that happened last Monday, or this Monday, that the person, two people, the guy who owns it and manages it, and then the man that used to manage another Starbucks or set as ours, his wife is a barista over there and makes coffee. And then, so the two of them were talking and said, wow, these walls would be perfect to put up some historical pictures from Superior. And then they asked if we, the historical commission, could make sure that the captions at the bottom of the pictures are appropriate. Okay. And so it'd be, you know, if you had whatever it is, like these all had a picture and then a caption underneath of it that says what it is, but they'd like to display on their walls pictures. So it's up to the historical commission to figure out what pictures you all would like to have, or if you've got recommendations for pictures.
Now, we had pictures in the pizza place that was down by Safeway.
No.
I'm not saying they came from the historical commission.
Uh-huh.
But they came, I don't know where they got those pictures from.
They got the town.
Oh, okay.
So in conjunction with our pizza place.
Yeah, I'll chat with them, yeah.
Because there's got to be, we've got to have some great, or even some pictures like this. You know, wouldn't it be fun to have, or, well, this woman here probably isn't from Superior, but interesting pictures like that, or pictures of the mine, or
there's a ton of pictures in the book.
Right, so you take a picture like that, and then they'll work to figure out how to get them blown out.
But we have to be careful if they don't take any pictures that have some copyright issues like
that. Yeah.
Boulder County Library.
Well, that would be another reason to have a conversation through here, to make sure that that are uniquely Superior. And so work with them to, if we have recommendations or how we want them framed even. I think, well, to find out, I would expect that they would pay for the framing and all that. And then, but they want to hang them on their walls.
Well, I've often wondered whatever happened to those pictures that were in the
pizza place. Wondered also, when the pizza place closed, they had some great pictures.
They're
there.
Pretty good size.
Yeah, we'll probably have to ask about who knows. If it was probably theirs, they probably took them under.
I just thought it would be fun sometime to have an outreach, maybe a coffee, talk about Old Town Superior. People would, you know, want to come to something like that. I bet they would. It sounds like they're receptive. It'd be a great way for the business community to get involved.
Right. Right. We have our,
now we have to have our Starbucks, right?
Yeah, you have to have your Starbucks. We have the last couple of First Friday coffee meetings we have with trustees. We've had them over there now. And last, the one we just did a week ago, or 2 weeks ago, whatever it was, we had so many people there. And then there were so many people sitting there, standing, waiting. As soon as we got up, they took our tables, you know.
Oh.
There was a lot of activity in there. Oh, yeah. It was a really fun thing.
Isn't there a picture, or was over in the motor vehicle department?
Yeah, I just made a note, because Chris, what's his last name?
Yes.
The trustee Hanson was checking into that, and that reminded me, Rita. So I've made a note to check with him. He was going to check with the county and see. Yeah.
I think he has it at his house.
Oh.
I mean, the copy.
Okay.
Oh.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, anyway, I'm saying you, the commission, the historical commission should and can make recommendations of pictures that might be of interest to put, to hang in the walls. And if you ever find it, it's a long, narrow, kind of industrial looking space, you know, because the Starbucks over here, and it's gray and the ceilings are, you know, just the middle rafters. And dark and painted and everything, but they would be nice in there. They'd be kind of interesting in there, and there's a really long wall, so there'd be.
It sounds like they're in communication with Mark. So.
Yeah, I'll see where he's at with it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Follow up on that.
And then I've got one more about that. There's a Firehouse Sub sandwich place that's going to be coming in soon here now, over there too. And I think we should have the fire truck there when they open up. And they do the ribbon cutting.
Oh.
If it's not in the shop by then.
Well, that's the thing. So I just said that to Clint, Mayor Folsom, and Matt, because we were over doing the tour of the Boulder Valley Ice. I said, because Clint said he had to go to another ribbon cutting. And I said, okay, so when we have a ribbon cutting for the Firehouse Subs, we got to take a fire truck over there. And then they all said, that's a great idea. I said, but it might be in being repaired. But if it isn't, or if it is, then later on we can have some event where we actually put the fire truck there. And then I said, anytime we have something in town that we might want to use the fire truck for as a, or even Boulder Valley Eyes, I told those guys over there, Jimmy who runs, or his assistant manager over there, said, if you have some youth hockey activity or something and you just want to have it out there as another thing, not for everybody to get on and all that, but just as an example of experience, we could start taking it out to more of these events.
I think that's a great idea.
Yeah, I think
as long as we have something to go with it, you know, either one volunteer that's there handing out brochures,
right,
getting donations,
yes,
something like that.
That's perfect.
So it's going to be by the string there, like.
Right next door to Starbucks, right.
And if you know the opening day, we can kind of delay, make sure the truck is
here. Yeah, I don't know. Do you know how close they are to opening?
I think they said
I'm not sure.
In a month or so.
I believe
it's
March 8th.
They're probably about a month away.
That's right.
March 8th.
It's March 8th. We take care of the new manager's daughter.
Oh,
so,
okay.
And I think yesterday she said it's March 8th.
Right. Now they won't do the ribbon cutting that same day. It usually takes a little bit longer.
Yeah.
And is the truck gone now?
Not yet.
Oh, okay.
It hasn't yet.
But it should be by the end of March, I'm sure.
I would anticipate so, yeah, by the end of March.
But, well, we could ask again, it would be Heather Craycraft from the chamber that sets those up.
Yeah.
Those ribbon cuttings, but maybe ask, or maybe the opening. Maybe Firehouse Subs don't care about the ribbon cutting as much as they would like to have it there for the
many people.
Yeah,
that'd be better.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other old business?
Well, actually, while we're on this, I'm just going to be the devil's advocate here. This, I think, this thing, if we want this fire truck to be at these various places, maybe it's time the town, well, let's see, how can I put this? Pulls their horns in. Somehow figures out how one or two of us can get this fire truck over to, I'm talking about on the commission, allow us to drive this thing over, like to Starbucks, get it displayed over there and set it up.
Yeah. And why won't they, why can't you drive it? Because it doesn't have seatbelts.
Insurance.
Insurance has some kind of employee.
I have to believe that somehow something can be worked out with that, and we would have to jump through some hoops, and I don't have a problem with that. That, I think, still needs to be addressed, and I have said I will not drop this.
Well, I think that's a good question to ask again. And there's a lot of volunteer people in a lot of organizations who drive vehicles for those organizations. And they're, as long as they're trained, you know, on how to drive it properly, which is not a problem. And then you should be able to be included as an authorized, trained, you know, fully instructed volunteer.
We're not asking for the whole commission, just a couple people.
Yeah.
But also, you guys, if it's not ever going anywhere, right, what comes first? We were saying, well, there were 6 events this year that you guys had to drive to. Right now, it's like 2. So it needs to, there needs to be a good enough reason for them. Because it's like, oh, well, for 4th of July and Christmas, that's easy. Why would we go through all the work if there's 2 events? But if we're saying, well, we're going to do the Labor Day Parade, we're going to do the...
That's exactly what I'm getting at.
Yeah, but we have to do those.
Or you have some event at the Boulder Valley Ice, you know, like some weekend tournament for hockey or something like that, or lacrosse or anything. But that's good. I think we can ask that question again, Brian, unless you don't need to bring it up at a board meeting.
Yeah.
Let's just ask, how would we authorize volunteer drivers after they've been trained and they have to have a valid driver's license and all that kind of stuff? Particularly once we get the seatbelts in and...
Well, and mentioning that our goal is that we're going to be doing 3 to 5 events this year.
The insurance company could have some kind of a rider for just that.
Well, you can do it. I mean, I know you can. It just that we just need to... Before, it wasn't very safe. You know, so it wasn't like a regular street car, legal street car.
Well, it has to be street legal.
Yeah, street legal. It has, and that was what I could understand. But once it's street legal, there's no reason why you guys can't. Certain people can't.
Well, yeah.
If you bring it out at the museum openings, there'd be a lot more.
I wouldn't have a problem doing some training or whatever is required.
Yeah.
No problem.
Or even with your own car, you know, anybody can drive as long as you give them permission to, and they have a driver's license. Yeah. But I think about all of the volunteers that drive for hospitals, nursing homes, the schools. I mean, once you've got the training, you can do it. It's really covered.
Yeah, so like in the past, you know, I've gone to, so Paul's checked with the town's insurance company, and, you know, the update's been like, you know, insurance says it has to be a town employee. But just so, like, so this, you know, doing this again and following up with those guys, just so the message doesn't get lost, maybe it'll have a little more push to it, is if, I'm not saying a letter, but if someone could email me, you know, kind of what was discussed here, you know? Mm-hmm. So I have a little, so, you know.
Yeah, it's say our goal for 2017 is for the fire truck to be at the museum openings. And
I guess if we want to go ahead and formulate another letter like we did for the cemetery over here, we can and come up with some bullet points and state our case.
I'll go ask Matt too before I meet today. Just take another look at it, run at it.
Yeah. I just, only because knowing the history, and I've gone to them a couple times, and I get the same answer, and I tell you guys the same answer, and I have certainly no stake in it, but just maybe push it a little bit more with supporting, why.
In the past, it's understandable why we couldn't, because it wasn't street legal, basically. But now, once it is, with blinkers and lights and seat belts and everything, once the interior is done out of the fire, I can't imagine why someone couldn't be trained.
Well, we appreciate you following up on that. Any other old business? In the new business, we'll be open on the 4th of March. And, anybody available? Who's available?
I'll be there.
We're going to be going. Cool.
might be there.
Yeah, that's enough. So, yeah, we understand your situation, Bob, so.
Yeah.
Well, I know, there was one other guy who came on that last opening, the guy came from the Garden Railway Society. Yeah, right, yeah, so. When I gave my program at the Garden Railway Society, I had information about the museum, so. Shootout at the OK Corral, I mean, shootout at the Superior Depot.
If we're gonna do refreshments for that, plan on who's going to.
Good idea.
Yeah, you know, when we did the ice cream before, I just ran over at like 10:30 or something to Target and brought a cooler and. I think it would be pretty simple, just.
Well, we could always do some waters from Costco or something.
Yeah, so.
Mega.
Maybe we'll just talk to the DMC. I don't think it's gonna be a big deal.
Yeah, that's.
But yes, we need to do that. Yeah.
Lindsay, we need to, on the side of that, so. So sometime around the third of March, we'll make a decision.
Yeah.
The big drop.
I've been gone so much lately, these two recent trips, I don't plan on going to Amfram on Monday, but Harry's considering it. Would you go if I have to go to Monday?
Oh, no, mine's just like, because it's clear out in the boonies, the other side of town, and I have to be back here to work.
Well, that's right.
I've got to see if it's realistic to get back here. But I would like to, if I get that one down, then call them in time.
Historic block date confirmation, Bob, tell me.
Don't miss the elections. Don't miss item three.
Okay, we know what I had a big red arrow pointing.
Yeah, the one that had the arrow at.
Okay, so, we've been talking about following the procedures a little bit more closely here lately, since we generally kind of do it by default. So, Brian is going to give you a little background and take it from here for a few minutes. My feeling has been that nobody's fault, it's kind of like, oh, we're supposed to have elections now. So we just kind of, okay, you go and do it, Larry, okay, then away we go. So, we want to be a little bit more transparent.
Yeah, so, yeah, talking with Patrick a little bit more about how the other committees do it. So, you know, I know we have a secretary and a treasurer, but we only need to do, you know, like a formal election for a chair and vice chair. So, we can do this, it's gonna be remain confidential. I'm gonna pass around, each member will get, you can just write down, if you want to nominate someone for a chair or vice chair, you can nominate yourself. You can nominate an existing person that is currently the chair or vice chair. So we'll just do chair and vice chair. Like I said, nominate yourself or someone else. I will gather those up and, again, in order to remain confidential, I'll list who's been nominated for each position. And then I'll, you know, do you want to, if it's two people or whoever it is, do you want to, do you accept this nominee, or do you want to be nominated? If yes, and it's more than one person, then we'll do it again, and you vote on those people, so. And chatting with Larry a little bit, just, I think it's, you know, whether, you know, just the course of last meeting's discussion about it, you know, if you don't feel comfortable doing it yourself or whatnot, but, so we'll.
Someone gives nominee, they can decline.
Yeah, you can decline it, yeah, sorry, so you can decline it.
And then there'll be a secret ballot.
Secret ballot.
Be a beautiful ballot. Be the greatest ballot since.
So, yeah, just.
Yeah, it is.
I mean, yeah, like, I don't know, Larry, you want to do this, right? I mean, that's probably the fairest way to.
I was gonna say, if you're happy with the current situation.
Yeah, it's not up to me, yeah, sir, this isn't, just more in chatting with Larry a little bit, I don't know if, Larry, you want to add to it? I know right now.
I think people should have an opportunity to nominate others or themselves and have a secret ballot.
Couldn't you have the nomination so it'd be, like, Larry, you want to be nominated in for chair? You want to nominate?
Seems like get nominated, yeah.
Well, but I don't know that it needs to be by, no. If people want to be nominated.
I think he's got it, just going.
Yeah.
A lot of paper.
Yeah, we'll do it real quick, real quick.
The commission.
Yeah, just.
Right, I'm not.
Just chair, chair and vice chair, that's it.
This just with a chair and vice chair?
Yeah, nominations for chair?
Yeah, that's why, just do a quick chair and vice chair on the same piece of paper.
Don't peek.
Again.
Don't cheat.
I don't know all our handwriting.
Change it.
Yeah, write with your left hand. Oh, no, you do anyway, no.
No, I'm going to keep it blue so they can't tell who it was.
Do it in red.
You can just fold it up and, yeah, just.
Can I use your?
Oh, I got one.
I have done.
Would you give me your mailing address?
Sure, you want to do that?
If you don't mind, just write it down there.
Yeah, to send the letter to?
Yeah, I'll send you a copy of that, yeah.
It's like home room election.
Yeah, I know, I didn't have.
Everybody else go out and eat their own.
That's just way too organized. I don't know, it's very typical of our usual procedure. Yeah, I think we're going up.
Thank you.
Just like current elections.
Now, the city town making us coordinate all this stuff. It's my fault, so.
Yeah, hey, let's get, for the record, I was, you know.
Watch out for the electoral college.
It is probably the fairest way to do it.
I thought it was so clever how you got past the public. Well, I was given this.
Or creek elect, whatever it was.
Yeah. Do you work every day and then go to?
No, so I'm subbing like 3 days a week and there are 2 days a week.
You still have a kid, they also haven't been there.
Score kids.
Oh, sure.
No, that's why I heard.
I know, I've already, I know, I've heard it. And I'm sure I'd love it, I just can't. Yeah, but I just need to think about that on the weekends, because I'm sure.
It's also open.
Yeah.
It's open every day except for.
That's what happens.
So every.
It's like a school break or something.
They have trips too, but boy, it really expensive.
They get filled up all the time, so I guess it's worth it for them.
So what if another?
Yeah, I think I've been there 3 times before I started working there, but seeing it through like a kid's eyes, I really appreciate the way that it's set up.
Yeah.
It was really interesting.
Kids, why are you talking about that? Where are they, where they get it all, they're supposed to go back. Maybe it's supposed to go back.
I had no idea how it goes. I have to be standing there with.
Are you trying to put in over in Europe or, what, Europe or Germany?
Germany or Great Britain.
Great Britain.
Good.
But that's getting, job may not be available now anymore.
I see, I thought they're about to.
Yeah.
They don't want to give art. So it'd be like art museum,
I've never won a time that I thought so quickly, I thought.
For exhibit areas.
Really?
Right now, the fortress and the basement.
Yes.
I don't think the last part.
I know.
And I'm not talking about anything other.
To the list.
I just saw they're doing some sort of like.
Assassination came out.
Well.
Oh, really?
La, 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 yeah, I like it, la, la, la. Now be nice.
Mr. Meyer?
All right, we'll just do, we'll first do the chair, so, Larry's been nominated, by everyone, so Larry, you are the only one.
Oh my God.
Let's give Larry a clap.
So Larry, yeah, so I think, so we need to vote, Larry, will you accept the nomination,
No.
Chair?
Luckily, I will not serve.
Yes.
Okay.
I Thank you, everybody.
Good leader.
So we have three different nominations for vice chair. Mary.
Who's vice
chair? Walt and Wally. So each of you three need to indicate if you would like to accept the nomination, then we'll vote on however many.
I don't mind not doing it either, so.
Walt?
I think I'm going to respectfully decline.
Okay.
Just because I think, you know, Mary's doing a good job. Walt's interested. New people and whatever. I've been there, done that, so let somebody else have a chance.
So now we need to vote. Yeah, one more quick vote between Walt and Mary and majority. Majority Walt.
Yeah, odd
numbers. And you just fill
yes.
Right.
Well, no.
Yeah. And support him. I collected them and changed
them. Now he's got to be watching.
I don't watch them.
Saturday Night Live.
Oh, yeah, Ally Baldwin?
He's got a definite job.
Doesn't know. The little Saturday Night Live thing that I just.
Yeah.
That one they did on the.
Oh.
It's unbelievable. Mary Spicer with. Yeah, Linda Spicer.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You can really watch TV up
there. Yeah, but it's worth staying up just. Yeah, I bet their viewership has gone up.
Yeah, they said that sort of didn't come off because the stage and Spicer was.
Any more in there? There we go.
Well, I think a few of us were trying to have a woman to represent it. Yeah.
Oh, I see.
That's
yes. That's a, yeah.
So I looked at it, who the heck is that?
All right. Looks like Mary Cartwright will retain her position as vice chair.
Thank you.
Close race.
There
we have it.
Okay. Sheesh. You're not too old yet. I don't know about that. Well, thank you again, everybody.
And thank you for our secretary we didn't get a chance to give her to get rid of it, but thank you, Karen and Bob.
Yeah.
You comfortable staying on as secretary so I don't vote?
Yeah, I don't know what the procedure is for secretaries.
There is none. It's kind of a volunteer. I mean, that's the thing. There's no, you know, the other commissions don't have, you know, an election of a secretary or a treasury, yeah. So it's kind of voluntary, yeah. So if you want to continue doing it,
I mean,
you know.
I'll do it, but if anybody, you know, wants to do it, I'm certainly willing to give it up.
Same way you're here at the treasury, not much to do with the treasury.
Yeah, I was telling Larry, like, even let's say if you didn't want to do it anymore and no one else wanted to do it, it would essentially just be
when I don't want to do it anymore, I'll
yeah, yeah, okay, yeah.
You're always saying it,
yeah.
Minutes.
Well, I'm saying, yeah, I was, yeah.
Stand for the minutes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, 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 I see what you're saying.
Yeah.
Do you have a statement for
that? Thank you.
Yeah, because you do a
fire
great
truck
job.
Account.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah. A statement for the fire truck account. I have been keeping up with it.
Oh, Oh, there it is.
Look at what happened since you've been gone.
Did you have another vacation in Belize with you?
Ready, I'm ready.
Ready, I bet you are. Okay, so the historic walk is whatever that second, first Saturday.
May 6th.
May 6th, thank you. So May 6th is definite, April 20th, the program's definite. Future, oh, okay, we did number five. Holy cow. So is there any other new business? Karen?
Okay, we had a call the other day from Denzel, and he was chatting away like Denzel usually does. But he had something pretty important, I thought. One of his grandchildren gave to him something that, 18 pages worth of something that Jenny had written. And it was all about their, when they left Illinois and came out to Superior. And she wrote like a journal or a diary of what his sister Jenny wrote from the time they left Illinois to coming out to Superior and all that. And so he's going to send it out to Wally and me. It's handwritten, and he says his copier isn't good enough to copy it so it's legible. But I think we can copy it, but we also might want to, you know, type it in. And, you know, we haven't had a chance to read it yet, but I think it'll be very interesting. It's 18 pages long.
My goodness. Wow.
What Jenny has written in the history of out here, and I think it's great.
So, Jenny wrote that?
Jenny wrote it and gave it to, apparently, one of the, was it a grandchild?
I believe granddaughter, yeah, I think.
Yeah, I think it was a granddaughter, and the granddaughter just turned it over to Denzel recently. So it's could be quite interesting.
Yeah.
And we'll see what it looks like when it arrives. Denzel sent me it pretty quickly. And we may want to, he of course wants it back.
Yeah.
But we'll see if we can get a good copier that will copy it.
Dark
enough, and I think probably the town hall has one here.
That's true, yeah.
But we may want to transcribe it to, you know, type it in too.
You can keep both of them, and maybe even share copies with Carnegie or something like that.
Yeah. It's almost like a written oral history. Mm-hmm. It's a written history. Yeah.
Good.
Okay, that's all I have.
Wally has something new.
Well, yeah, and Denzel was in a good mood. Apparently, they're getting over an ice storm and stuff that they had out there. But he was talking about Danny a little bit and said, Danny's kind of down in the dumps. So I went down, stopped by Wednesday after I got done with the rec center. And I had a brief conversation with Danny. And when I say brief, I mean it was brief. I think he allowed me 3 minutes, and then I was, I think, very politely
dismissed.
He's walking on, he's on a cane. Apparently he's in quite a bit of pain because he fell when he was at the rehab place, and so he's wanting to go in now and maybe get his neck checked and see if the rods are still okay in his neck. He's kind of, because of this, he's down in the dumps a little bit. He was telling me that, I don't know if it was the day I was there, but that's the first time he's, if you will, gotten really dressed. He said he's finally got put his pants on, he's got shoes on, he's out walking around. So I think he's just been laying in his bed. So I didn't get a chance to do much of anything else. He said, well, thanks for stopping by. And he basically got up and started heading towards the bedroom. So I let myself out. That was, like I said, I'm making it.
Denzel's been talking to him on the phone.
Yeah. So I didn't get to discuss anything else or nothing else. But he's doing okay.
He's still going through rehab and so forth at his house?
No. That stuff is all over with. I think Medicare only allowed him, Medicare or Medicaid, whichever one it is, only allowed him so many visits, and that's over with. Maybe that's why he started down in the dumps, because he doesn't have that contact.
Thanks for the the update, Wally. Any other new business?
Well, so I was thinking, this is kind of early to think about it, but with the sort of results, future events stuff for the 4th of July parade, I was thinking about, like, last year, how we were, you know, one side of us had, like, the opening and everything, and the other side had the whatever, with the contest thing. but it'd be nice to have something at our booth to attract children or something. But what if we had, like, a coloring sheet of the fire truck or something like that that we could hand out? I didn't know how long it takes to put together, like, a coloring thing, just an outline of a fire truck. But,
we usually have coloring books available to kids.
Yeah, but what if we had, like a fire truck themed sheet or something like that?
I was trying to think, I don't know how to do that, but I think we can do it because we've done it before, so.
And have, like, colors there.
Yeah, that's good.
Like those little, like, four colored boxes.
Yeah, we need.
You can also get those just really cheap fire truck hats at, like, Party City. That would be kind of fun.
Yeah.
They're probably $1.50 or something.
Well, actually.
Or they could win it, you know, if they do something.
We left the truck outside and had the booth inside. We have a table by the truck, all the stuff on the floor.
Yeah.
I would have a booth and be sure to see the truck on the way out of there. Yeah, I think that this will probably happen. Maybe we need to work on location so we don't have other people's lines make it so no one can find our booth. So.
Yeah. Bad location last year, yeah.
Whoever was next to us, they were. I can't remember what they had, but I could put over the pancakes.
Now, did we discuss last year about putting the fire truck next to our tent, or did we discuss it and decided that was not a good idea?
I don't think it was discussed, but I don't think it's probably safe to.
Where the tent is. Can't drive.
It's hard to drive in there.
Well, yeah, but they seem to be able to get those big box trucks from me.
For Saturday.
They have. Yes, they have.
Not recently.
Thank you.
All in all, with ATV and cars. That's why we didn't have the our antique cars. They couldn't drive the cars.
Okay. Well, and I couldn't remember if we discussed it and it was a reason why.
Well, we could put our booth by the fire truck outside. But the truck was.
Yeah, lots of people were looking at the truck.
The truck was an hot item for kids. Yeah.
Sure was.
Take pictures of kids. I forgot to count how many times I sit in things. Once they have access to the pancakes.
Yeah.
I think the table probably should be by the truck.
Well, a table by the truck and an A booth in the usual booth place.
Well, or I mean the booth by the truck. Why do
that's
we separate?
That's kind of what I'm thinking too, because that truck's going to attract more people in there. Yeah, most people, many people.
Yeah.
Notice
that. Right, yeah.
I guess you try it and see what we get. Put that in your thinking cap there, this point.
Don't the fire, Rocky Mountain Fire, have their truck there too?
Yeah, we were
so right beside them.
Yeah, right behind them, yeah.
Yeah, we were right behind them. Yep.
Excellent.
And that was so they could get out.
Yeah, right.
Let's work on that. I think we could approach Alan on making an image, taking an image, and making it at least a color of one. Fire hats.
Then they have something to take home with them and remember what they saw during
I know when they do events out at the Railroad Museum, they have the local fire department area there too, and they also hand up, they use the little hats, and they also have some sticker fireman's badges too. Mm-hmm. So they can stick on the kids.
Well, sure. Are we going to try to have, like, a display board of, you know, the process of.
Yeah, probably. Because aren't we doing a display, right?
Yeah. So
or we're doing an exhibit, right?
Cool if it was
with
like
that same month?
On a, you know, what do you call it? Like, you can clean it up.
Okay, the commission members come down and sign the letter. Katie filled off one on this nice paper here, too. So.
Yeah.
So there's a motion to adjourn as long as it's.
So moved.
There it is.
Is this yours?
No, I think it was Larry's.
Second.
Larry.
calendar in?
Larry.
Oh, Larry.
Larry did.
Larry did.
Yeah, you know, I'll just, you guys, if anyone, if there's still some left in March, or I could, is anyone interested in them? And I can.
Yes, yeah.
Okay. Okay, I'll just go back and see how many we have left. I don't know how many we have left, but if so, I'll.
For sale, these are from Carnegie for free, so.
Oh. I didn't know if they were giving them somewhere else or not.
I'll see, so three or four of you?
I like have two.
Okay, let me just see how many we have and we can figure out.
Okay.
Payment later.
That's right.
Yeah, that's it.
Here we go. Oh. Sign, any signatures?
Yes, we have to sign.
Yeah.
Pay attention now.
I have this proud my school teacher at that job.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine that you would be that.
And my wife is.
The sheets are all there, they're summarized.
I feel like a lot of it was.
That is really good.
Yeah.
sign in for Jill. Yeah, but most of those handwriting.
Yeah, that's a good sign, Jill.
Oh. Well, Jill Roberts.
I guess so.
Yep.
Right, right here.
All under the name.
And I guess you could always put your initials on there.
Ah, doesn't matter.
Well, yeah, because we don't want the FBI coming.
That's right.
I mean, that's perfect.
And I signed my boss's name.
I'm going to have to make a copy.
You know, that's a copy of this.
Okay, that'll work.
Her persona or something.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Hey, you need a.
Yeah.
So how is this? Is he still?
Yeah, sorry.
He's 58, he's 58.
The anesthetic from that minor.
You're doing okay?
But I think he's forgetting it.
Nope, I was gonna ask you. You have a heart problem. You have that on the medication.
She went to morning meeting yesterday, which is morning meeting, getting the surgical stuff down.
No, I didn't have any of that. Basically, the only thing I've ever taken for my heart, even right after the surgery, was.
I can speak to that.
You know.
I started reading my list.
That had been all for it, it's all I've written down. You got my, because I go in once a year and they don't give me blood tests.
Use it now.
Oh, she does.
Yeah, and also Gail. Me, I just did like this because if I, and no one ever told me that, if I were racing.
That's a good idea, because that was.
Also.
Otherwise, yeah.
No, I really.
Tremendous, I don't all break my head.
Yeah, don't.
I'm not gonna shout, well, I'm just saying.
Oh, thank you.
I would like you.
Young spring.
It's been perfect.
Yeah, that's good, I think that's good.
Yeah, we might as well start that one.
They don't get.
We're gonna go for lunch and I gotta go over to Longmont. Over there, well, picked it up, it's been over there.
Oh, yeah.
Wally and I made a dash to Larry's one morning.
Service it. Get ready to go.
Sometimes, you know, computers are sometimes. You thought he'd save.
Fairly soon.
He didn't save.
But the news, the car is going.
Then we printed copies and, oh, yeah, we did, so.
Candy world.
They got it, yeah.
It's a big art. It's over there on 66. And it's gonna go there by radiation, because it's. Set it up.
So, oh, yes, to talk to him, to talk to him about somebody.
Well, yeah, when I.
Friend of mine.
That's that problem sitting right there, first car.
I have.
Just a little bit newer than one you had, but basically.
Some people make a lot of.
Not too bad.
Well, some people have problems.
Thanks for coming to here.
None of us got tired. It was a good experience.
So that's going, and then I sort of have to go back over.
Say, but. It doesn't, and my friend that went through it.
Picked it up.
That was back in 1983.
Yeah, so that was a while. Nine motorhome that we gotta go.
Said he had problems at all.
Turn signals weren't, brake lights weren't. And of course, then when I was driving down the road and I dropped the throttle on the motor.
Almost. If he needs to talk to somebody about that.
Exhaust brake comes on.
He can give me a call.
By the brakes on the car. Yeah, it actually goes from front right
she actually have a heart attack, or was it because she was a little short on oxygen, and she thought she might have had a heart attack? So stint, is that fair? Oh, no, she did. Just because she was trying to keep her every once in a while doesn't mean it's a red Christmas lights and pointing crying.
Somebody on there.